I want to start with number 4. No, number 8 is much better. Number 8. So let's do f of x equals x squared, which we're very familiar with, right? That is f of x. But then they give me g of x is 3 over 2x minus 3, which I'm not as familiar with. What's the domain of f of x? Well, that's all real numbers. You can put anything you want into x squared and tell me what the output is. But if I ask you for the domain of g, well, remember what you're asking yourself is, what is x not allowed to equal? I think x is allowed to equal 0, because I could compute g of 0, and I'd get 3 over 0 minus 3, I'd get negative 1. I think you guys are right. Let me show how to compute the domain. What I'm going to do is I'm going to say that 2x minus 3 is not allowed to be what? 0. Because we can't have a 0 in a fraction of a denominator, you know, in the denominator of a fraction. So 2x is not allowed to equal 3. So x is not allowed to equal what? Okay. So my domain would be, well, from negative infinity to 3/2, union 3/2 to infinity, but we have open parentheses because we don't want to include what? 3/2. Okay. Now, if you put the bracket, that means 3/2 is allowed, right? So we don't want that. Okay. So to finish up here, if they ask me to compute, as they do, something like this, f g of 1/2, what does that mean? That means we're going to multiply the functions. So two ways to do it. One would be compute f of 1/2 and compute g of 1/2 separately. Now f of 1/2 is 1/4. G of 1/2, I can work it out. If I put a 1/2 in there, I get 1 minus 3 is negative 2, so I get negative 3/2. One-half times 1/2, that's how you square something. So that's 1/4. See me after. We got to go, okay? But let me just finish this. To get the final answer, I'll multiply these two outputs, and I get 1/4 times negative 3/2, and I get negative 3/8. Okay? So there's a start.
Makes sense.
And we will talk more about 1/5 next time for sure. All right? You guys have a nice weekend and work hard. Dan had a question. Emily had a question. You got it now?
Thank you.
Are you free now or no?
Left.
Okay.
And what do you have to do?
Yeah, we'll put it out before we get out of here.
Why don't I have a chance?
Oh, yeah, class, and we'll do as quick as I can, I'll see if I can do that, it'll be nice, man. Yeah. All you want is your litigation. So we distribute. That's not there. Not sure. Okay, here's why it didn't work. Cube root of x times cube root of x.
I wonder if I hold it down.
Is that here?
No.
Square root of x times square root of x. What you would need to do is cube root of x times cube root of x times cube root of x. For it to be x. So this trick that works for square root. And so now what the heck did you do? I think.
There's every new.
Yeah, you do. And I think his hint is what comes into play.
Yeah, that's what I figured out down here.
Okay. So these are both cube roots. You gotta use that formula back.
Okay.
I think